welcome to the Planning Analytics Deep Dive, where we explore the depths of planning analytics one dive at a time. I'm Andrew, and today we're going to use TM1py and ChatGPT to analyze financial data from a TM1 cube. So there's a few things that we need to get started with this project. We need an OpenAI API key, which you can get with the paid version of ChatGPT. I'm also using financial modeling prep to source the financial statements. So you can get a free API key from them as well if you want to follow along with this example. You can also use any data in TM1. Might be a little more interesting using your own organization's data. Then last but not least, of course, we're going to be using Python and TM1py for the scripting of this. I've got a couple of links here on the screen as well to help get you started with OpenAI documentation, financial modeling prep as well, and then getting started with TM1py for instructions on how to get that up and running as well. Okay, so let's take a look at the scripts that we're using for this example today. There's two of them. The first one is, the load financials. So we're going to be loading the financial statement data from financial modeling prep. You can see that first function right up here. We're passing in the statement. So we're going to be loading the three primary financial statements. We're passing in the stock ticker for the company we want to load the data for, and then our API key. We're getting the JSON output and then converting that to a pandas data frame for ease of manipulation and loading into TM1. So then in our next function, we're sort of preparing that data frame a bit, excluding some accounts and doing some other things. Then we have a function here to just check and ensure that we have the proper accounts in Planning Analytics to load our data to. And then we have our main function where we're passing in the three financial statements. We're connecting to TM1 using TM1py, connecting to this specific cube where we're then going to write the data frame of all of our data. Then we're passing in the ticker as an argument here so we can, run this from a turbo integrator process and, pass a parameter and make it a little bit more dynamic. So that's the first step, right? Getting our financial statement data into Planning Analytics. You might already have that with your financial statement data that you have existing in TM1. Okay, then the next script is where the sort of magic happens, right? So this is the one where we're going to connect to GPT, pass that data, and ask it to provide us some analysis. So for this script, the first thing that we do is we connect to TM1 to extract our data. That's our first function. Then we're going to summarize that data so that we can just pass a bit less to ChatGPT, make it a little bit faster and cost us a little bit less money. The way that this runs right now, it's very, very inexpensive. This query that you're going to see, I think it costs like 3 cents to run it, but it does cost money. So we generate our summaries based on just a sampling of the accounts. And then here's the key function, right? So with this function, we are using our OpenAI API key, easy for me to say. The model that we're using is the latest GPT-4o, which has got a little bit higher max token than GPT-4. It's optimized in some other ways as well. I'll let you guys read up on that. And so what we're doing is essentially what you would do if you were just typing into ChatGPT yourself, right? We're kind of defining what we want the role of GPT to be. In this case, it's an AI that's trained to provide financial analysis based on financial statements. And then we have a prompt that we're going to pass to it. So I sort of started the prompt here a bit to say, please analyze the financial data that's going to be provided in these summaries that we created previously. And then also gave the user a little bit more flexibility to concatenate something to the end of that to, make it a little bit more specific to what you want to do. Then I've defined the max tokens that we want to use in this query, and I set the temperature here to 1.1. So, say it in the comments here, but the temperature is used to control the kind of randomness of this, right? So the lower it is, the more precise and maybe boring it might be. And the higher the temperature, anything above one, it starts to get a little bit more creative, but obviously there's a risk of it, making no sense. So we're going to give it a little bit of creativity here and use a temperature setting of 1.1 in our example. All right. And then we've got, lastly, after the analysis is created, we're going to load that into our TM1 cube so we can view it directly in Planning Analytics. So then in our main function, we are defining our cube. It's a financial statements cube again. We've got an MDX query that basically just gets everything for a given ticker. And then we're going to call each of those functions that we just outlined previously. So we're going to extract the data, generate the summaries, ask GPT to analyze those summaries. And then we connect to TM1 using TM1py, and we load the analysis there. And, you know, again, we're using arguments here that we can pass from Turbo Integrator to make everything a little bit more dynamic. All right. So let's take a look at the example. So on the screen here, you see we've got, you know, a few tickers here, loaded the financials already for all of them, ran the insights for a couple as well. But let's just try to run this for Amazon. All right. So if I click the button here to run analyze with GPT, it's going to take, I don't know, maybe 15, 20 seconds. It's, you know, analyzing all of that data, all of the summaries, I should say, you know, providing its analysis, and it's going to load it back in here. And, you know, this is still a pretty simplistic application, but also pretty powerful, I would say, right? To be able to give you some basic financial analysis, some key insights, some recommendations. So there it says it's done successfully. So let's take a look at what it's telling us, right? So it's telling us the data spanned 5 years, key trends, then it breaks it down for us, kind of summarizes what we can see on the left in revenue, profitability, some balance sheet stuff, cash flow, calculates some ratios for you. And then it's even got some recommendations down here. Looks like some of it even got cut off. You know, it'll spit out quite a bit of stuff here. So what maybe we want to just give it a simpler example or something that we can see on our screen a little shorter. So maybe I'll just change this to say, you know, provide the recommendations, key insights and recommendations in iambic pentameter. We'll make a little Shakespearean thing, probably a little shorter. As we click our analyze again, it's going back through that same script right now, hopefully going to give us something, you know, a little bit more funny, perhaps. Well, it's a pretty good one, right? So in these 5 years, the trend is quite profound with revenues that climb off stable ground. You guys can read the rest, right? But, you know, essentially we're loading data from an external source, right? From a web API using TM1py. So, you know, example of being able to connect to anything, right? Get your data into TM1 using Python, and then provide ChatGPT with a sample of that data and ask it to give us some AI-driven analysis. Thanks for watching this episode of the Planning Analytics Deep Dive. I hope you found this exploration of ChatGPT and TM1py useful and are inspired to give it a try. And until next time, remember to do good TM1.